Thank you so much, Professor, for engaging with us so far on these different segments. The next one, I have planned as a surprise round for you, right? So this is going to be a rapid fire round. To quickly explain to you, I'm going to ask a few personal, professional, insightful questions to you. And we have only one condition. You have to answer them as fast as you could. And of course, if you are not comfortable, you can always say a pass to the question. But my request is going to be try to answer as much as questions as possible.
Okay, I'll try.
Sure, Professor. Okay, so here we begin. You can choose to answer the following questions in a word or phrase. Yeah. First question. What is the one technology that you believe that's crucial for our future?
Artificial intelligence. That's part of my job, anyway.
Okay, great. What is the one fundamental value that every engineer should possess?
Ethics. Yeah.
Great. Who is your one favorite professor or teacher when you were a student?
My late supervisor, Professor Kipo Wong.
Great. This is an exploratory question. How many countries have you visited? I also have a follow-up, but let me pose you this question first.
Well, really, I lost count of how many countries I have visited. Especially, I've been working on the ship and I've been joining a lot of cruises as well. But answer the question of which one is my favorite one, I would say Norway.
Norway, great. Okay. That's the first round, Professor. So now I'm going to give you the set of choices for the next set of questions. You can choose one of the options for the questions below. Yeah. Are you a beach person or a mountain person?
A beach person. I love the sea.
Great. Are you a morning person or a night person?
A night owl. I stay up.
Night owl. Great. So, which is your favorite one? I think this also comes from hearing out your experiences, right? And I'm sure this is going to be hard. Which is your favorite one? Traveling through airplanes or traveling through ships?
Ships, 100%, ships.
Great. What is the one thing you value in impact, either depth or scale?
I look at scales. I look at the breadth. Yeah. Of course, in terms of the individual one, then you need to go in depth, but rather, I would rather to have a much more broader impact.
Great. So this is a COVID special question that I'm going to ask. Which engagement do you prefer with people? In-person, face-to-face, or virtual engagements?
Well, I would say that the COVID-19 gave us the opportunity that I'm getting very familiar with the virtual now. And in that case, I have to answer virtual. Okay, although people really say that, okay, they still prefer face-to-face, but I still see that virtual give us the possibility that I can reach out to so many people. That's how I answer.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, the power of virtual is, it's going beyond what we expected, right? Especially in the COVID. Thank you for answering that. So this is a question with respect to volunteering. According to you, what is the most required skill in a volunteer? Yeah, either technical skills or managerial skills.
Between technical and managerial, I'd rather to have the managerial skills. Because in a way that, if you got a good managerial skill, you should be able to look at the people that got the good technical skill. But it may not be vice versa. Because after all, we're working with people. I think it's important.
Thank you, Professor. So I think that's a good segue for moving into some questions with respect to IEEE. This is going to be my favorite thing. You can feel free to explain the answers to these questions in this round. But you have to explain it very briefly. Yeah.
Okay.
So let's begin. One thing you really like about volunteering with IEEE.
Okay. I would say it's a networking opportunity. Well, you're meeting people, and also I have the opportunity as well for volunteering with IEEE. There's a lot of opportunities, a lot of committees and a lot of positions as well.
Great. Of all the experiences and the events you attended with IEEE, what is the best memorable IEEE event you will always cherish?
Well, I do believe it's one of the first section congress I ever attended. So it was in Tampa, 2005. And then, this was the opportunity that I really see how the big organization worked in IEEE. Session Congress.
That's amazing. That's amazing. Who is your first mentor in IEEE?
Again, my late supervisor, Professor Kipper Wong.
Great, great. The first ever volunteer task you performed with IEEE as a volunteer?
Okay, getting refreshment and getting the chairs and the table set up.
that's very similar to what I did as well. Thanks a lot for sharing that. Yeah. Again, a COVID special question. The count of the number of webinars you spoke during the lockdown. Don't tell me you lost the count.
I haven't lost count because I do keep track on my calendar. And I can tell you that I'm coming up to 59 tomorrow.
Wow. Okay. 59. That's amazing. That's really wonderful. Inspirational numbers. Yeah. One thing you admire about IEEE as an organization?
Okay. I would say it's a democratic system. And also is the diversity that you embrace, and also the opportunity given to the volunteers and the recognition given to the volunteers as well.
That's amazing. Yeah. One thing you want to change or transform within IEEE?
I do believe that, well, the volunteers, that they need to have the recognition and also the incentive as well. I mean, it's amazing that, well, when we go to buy something, well, we do have some kind of credit given back to us. But I do believe that for the volunteers, well, although I do not say that, well, they should be really rewarded financially or those kind of things, but rather there should be some kind of recognition proportional to the time they put in. Maybe they can get some credit, well, they can pay for the courses, well, in ILN and those kind of things. So we're looking at a micro volunteering and micro credential and micro award as well. That I'll be looking at.
That's very well said, Professor. I think, and there you go. So we have completed the rapid fire questionnaire. Thank you so much for engaging with us sportively and in an energetic way, answering all the questions. It's really kind of you. So before I conclude actually this specific session, I'd like to ask your final thoughts. The elections are also around the corner. And why do you think that every IEEE member should cast their vote and decide the leadership?
Okay, I do believe that every one of us will pay our membership deal. We're involved as a membership. We should get to know more about the organization. And really, well, you can get to know actually more, of course, through all the documentation, through the website. But bear in mind that there are the volunteers involved as well. You can also learn so much as well. And I admit that I learned so much from the past leaders I interact with. So I would suggest that you cast a vote because I hope that you spend some time to study every one of the candidates' background. And also what they have achieved. And also in terms of the how you cast a vote and decide on leadership. So really in a way that you consider you're part of it. So I do believe that you are one part of IEEE. This is just a minimum thing that you can do.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Professor. I think I'm also thinking like many among the audience may have other questions. And would you be prepared or interested to do similar interviews if there are such requests and further questions from members?
Yes, I'm more than happy because, as I said, I'm always looking forward to have the opportunity to interact with the members. And after all, I keep on saying that IEEE is a member organization. Well, we are part of it. You are part of it as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor. I think it was a really insightful conversation. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts. So in a so interesting way, and I also liked seeing, a lot of very interesting learnings, right, from your experiences. And whenever we talk with a mentor or a senior person in IEEE, that's the priceless things we always get. Wishing you all the very best for your candidature. Do continue inspiring us with your dedicated commitment and leadership. Thank you so much once again, Professor.
Yeah, thank you so much for the opportunity once more. And as I said, I look forward to you guys become the leaders as well. After all, we have to pass the baton to every single one of you. Thank you again. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Professor.
Okay.